वागर्थायो संपृक्तौ वागर्थ प्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ येनाक्षरसमाम्नाय मदगुम्मे महेश्वरात् कुर्सिन्याकरं कोटिं तस्मै पाणिनेय महावाक्यकारं वरुच्यं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मित्रयं धातुर्ब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिपशुबन्धादिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमाभाज्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं लीलापुस्तकधारिणीं अभेदाञ्जाड्यान्धकारापहाम् हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्देतां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं मुक्तिप्रदां शारदां दत्त्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुण्यां करोम्यहं पाणिनीयप्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदीम्। वी लुक एट निपात एकाजनांग सूत्र विच गिव्स अ प्रक्रिय संज्ञा टू निपात विच इज एक एकाच एंड अनांग विच इज नॉट आंग। नाउ व्हाट इज दिस आंग? फॉर दैट वी आर लुकिंग एट दिस सूत्र ईषदर्थे क्रियायोगे मर्यादा विविधौ च यः एतमातम नितम विद्यात वाक्यस्मरणयो अंगित। सो नित एंड अंगित मीनिंग आ विच इज अंगित विदाउट न्यकार एज एन इथ एंड आंग वेर न्यकार एज एन इथ। देर आर टू सच कैटेगरीजेशन। सो आंग एंड आ इज अंगित एंड आंग इज नित। सो वॉट इज द कैटेगराइजेशन देर? ईषदर्थे क्रियायोगे मर्यादौ एंड अभिविदौ दैट विच इज देर एतमातम नितम विद्यात। सो कंसिडर दैट एज नित मीनिंग आंग इज इन ईषदर्था क्रियायोग मर्यादा एंड अभिविधि मीनिंग्स वेर एज आ विच इज नॉट नित दैट इज इन वाक्य एंड स्मरण। सो वाई दिस कैटेगराइजेशन? सो एग्जाम्पल्स आर गिवन हियर ईषदर्थ। सो आ उष्णम विल बी ओष्णम एंड देन क्रियायोग वेन देर इज क्रियायोग देन देर इज अ उपसर्ग संज्ञा। सो आ प्लस इणगतो धातु लोट्लकार मध्यम पुरुष एकवचन फॉर्म विल बी एहि। सो दिस इज लोट्लकार मध्यम पुरुष एकवचन यू विल गेट एहि। देर विल बी संधि आ एंड उष्णम देर विल बी गुणसंधि ओकार एंड हियर आ प्लस ई विल ऑल्सो गिव यू गुणसंधि एहि। मर्यादा एंड अभिविधि दे आर बोथ लिमिट्स बट मर्यादा इज एक्सक्लूसिव लिमिट मीनिंग अप टू दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग एंड अभिविधि इज इंक्लूसिव लिमिट मीनिंग अप टू एंड इंक्लूडिंग दैट। सो आ मुक्ते हे संसार। सो संसार इज अप टू मुक्ति नॉट इंक्लूडिंग मुक्ति आफ्टर मुक्ति इंक्लूडिंग मुक्ति अवस्था इज नॉट संसार बट संसार इज अप टू द लिमिट ऑफ मुक्ति एक्सक्लूसिव लिमिट। एंड आ ब्रह्म भुवनाथ देर इज संसार संसार ब्रह्मलोक इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ संसार देर फोर दैट इज एन इंक्लूसिव लिमिट। सो वाई दिस डिफरेंशिएशन? इन दिस डिफरेंशिएशन देर इज संधि और नो संधि दैट इज बींग मैंशनड हियर। सो वेन इट इज आंग देन इन दीज मीनिंग्स देर इज संधि बट इन वाक्य और स्मरण मीनिंग्स। सो वाक्य आ एव मन्यसे सो इन द वाक्य ओ नाउ दैट काइंड ऑफ मीनिंग वाक्य एंड स्मरणे इन रिकलेक्शन ऑल्सो आ ओ एवं किल तत् देर ऑल्सो आ इज देर दैट इज अंगित मीनिंग न्यकार इज नॉट इत देर यू डोंट डू संधि सो आ विल बी सेपरेट। सो आ एवं देर विल बी नो संधि इन बोथ केसेस वाक्य एंड स्वरण। ओके सो देन अन्यत्र ज्ञित आ ईषत उष्णम इत्यादि देर विल बी संधि इन सच केसेस। प्रगृह संज्ञा इज नॉट गिवन देर। सो प्रगृह वेर एवर देर इज प्रगृह संज्ञा सो the earlier I missed the earlier so vakya smarane or angit a evam nu manyase a evam kila tat that example that we looked at there the pragriya sanya is given so there is no sandhi so because of pragriya sanya when pragriya sanya is given there is no sandhi no application of sandhi whereas anyatra elsewhere there is nit akara is going to have nyakara as in it, so it will become ang. Then there is sandhi. Prakriya sanya is not given. When prakriya sanya is not there, then sandhi takes place. Oth, the sutra is oth. The anurutti is nipata pragruyam. So oth, okara has taken taparakaranam, meaning limited to the dvimatrika o. That okara, which is a nipata, and by okara, what do you mean? Okara ending words. So okara ending nipata is going to get the sanya of pragruya. So pragruya sanya is given. Odantaha nipata pragruya syat. Odanta. So okara is at the ending of whichever word. That word will be called as pragruya only when it is a nipata. It should be nipata also. Meaning asatto vachin, chadi gana ityadi that we have seen earlier. So aho ishaha. This aho is nipata because it is in chadigana and it is okara ending. Aho, okara ending nipata will get pragriya sanya and is becoming pragriya, there will be no sandhi. So aho ishaha in bahuvachana sambodhana. So this, as I mentioned, there is no 8 bar 3, it is sambodhana prathama. So sambodhana prathama in bahuvachana ishaha. Bho ishaha, so aho ishaha, this okara will not have sandhi because it will get pragriya sanya. Sambuddha shakalya setavanarshe. So this sutra, sambuddha, sambuddhi is a sanya for sambodhana ekavachana. When the sambodhana is in ekavachana, that particular word is called as sambuddhi. So in sambuddhi, sambuddha, शाकल्यस्य मतेन इतौ अनार्षे. सो दि पदच्छेद संबुद्धौ शाकल्यस्य इतौ अनार्षे. अनार्षे आर्ष प्रयोग, आर्ष मीन्स व्हाट? आर्ष इज दैट विच इज यूज बाय ऋषि, मीनिंग छांदस इन दि वेदास. सो अनार्षे मीन्स व्हेन इट इज नॉट आर्ष, मीनिंग नॉट यूज इन दि वेदास. So when it is not in the Vedas, and itau means when iti follows, iti should be following what? This oath and pragriyam. Pragriyam is the sanya given. Oath has also anuvritti from the earlier sutra. So this okara, which is in the sambuddhi, but that is not in the Vedas, outside the Vedas, means loke ityartha. Shakalya matena, shakalya vayakarana acharya says that that time that will get a, that okara ending word will become pragriya, will get a pragriya sanya. Sambuddhi nimittakah okaraha va pragriya avaidike itau pare. So when this okara is in sambuddhi, okara ending word in sambuddhi, in the sambodhana prathama, prathama vibhakti sambodhana, and it should be ekavachana, only in ekavachana it will get sambuddhi sanya. That sambuddhi nimittakah okara va, va, why va? Because shakalyasya matena. Shakalya acharya says so. Others have a different opinion, therefore va, vibhasha. There can be pragriya sanya or there may not be pragriya sanya. So avaidike ita upare. Only when it is outside the Vedas and iti should be following. So example is what? Vishnu iti. So he Vishnu iti, when he Vishnu iti, that kind of a usage is there, then this Vishnu is sambuddhi because it is sambodhana ekavachana, then it is followed by iti and it is outside the Vedas. So Vishnu is a sambodhana outside the Vedas, it can be in Puranas for example. Then this okara ending Vishnu, this will get what? This okara of Vishnu will be called as pragriya, and therefore there won't be sandhi between the two. Now this is as per the what? As per Shakalya Mata. So if at all you take that Vibhasha, then there won't be Sandhi. If you do not take that Vibhasha, then what will happen? No Pragriya Sanya. There won't be Pragriya Sanya. You are not taking Shakalya Mata. And thereby what will happen? Vishnu Iti. There will be Hoyavaya Sandhi. You will get Vishnaviti. And then either you will get Vishnaviti, or if you apply Lopa Shakalya after that, Yakara Vakara Lopa can take place. Thereby you will get Vishnu iti. So there are three forms. One is this Vishnu iti, Pragriya Sanya, no Sandhi between these two. एंड देन सेकेंड इज वॉट लोपशाकल्य देर इज अ ड्रॉप सो यू ड्रॉप अ वकारा विल वैनिश बाय लोपशाकल्य इफ यू डू नॉट अप्लाई लोपशाकल्य एंड प्रगृह संज्ञा इज ऑल्सो नॉट टेकन देन देर विल बी थर्ड फॉर्म एज टू एचो एवा वकारा विल सर्वाइव सो विष्णुविति नाउ एज वी हैव सीन अर्लियर लोपशाकल्य इज इन दी एट चैप्टर त्रिपादी and therefore after vishna iti vakara lopa vishna iti there can't be any sandhi there cannot be guna sandhi of the sixth chapter because you cannot go back from tripadi so the form will be vishna iti maya unyo va vo va so maya unyaha vaha va is a sutra so maya mai is a pratyahara starting with nyamagana nam Nyama, that Nyama, so Nyamaganam Sutra Ma, the second in the Sutra, Nyama, starting with that, ending with Kapai Sutra Yakara, that is the Pratyahara May. So Mayaha Panchami, so May should be preceding, meaning May Antargata, Pratyahara Antargata, Akshara should be preceding, Unj should be, Unj is a particle, Unj is a particular particle in the Chadigana, so that should be following which will become a sthani and that in turn should be followed by ach meaning what unj particle chadigana unj preceded by mai antargata akshara and followed by ach a vowel will get optional vakara so vaha va vibhashaya there is a vibhasha that it can unj can be replaced by vakara optionally सो मयः परस्य ऊंजः वः वा वकार आदेश वा स्यात् अचि परे सो एग्जाम्पल इज किम उक्तम नॉट किम उक्तम किम उ उक्तम सो किम उ उक्तम दिस उ इज ऊंज किम उ नकार विल गो अवे सो द कंटेंट इज उ किम उ उक्तम इज द प्रयोग सो किम उ उक्तम नाउ दिस ऊंज उकार कैन ऑप्शनली बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय वकार सो व्हेन यू डू दैट व्हाई बिकॉज मय Maya Makara is preceding and Ach is following this Unj. So, Unj, U is sandwiched between Maya and Ach. Then this can optionally, Unj, U can be replaced by Vakara optionally. So, when you replace what will you get? Kim Vakara Uktam. So, Kim Vuktam. The form is Kim Vuktam here. This is the first form. Then, if you use Prakriti Bhava, meaning what pragriya sanya for unj then what will happen because vibhasha is there if you use the vibhasha of vakara adesha then vakara will replace ukara there is no prakriti bhava because there is no pragriya sanya if you do not take that option then prakriti bhava will be there when pragriya sanya is there and thereby with pragriya sanya for unj prakriti bhava will be there so pragriya sanya is the first karya a and then B will be Prakriti Bhava. This will be the resultant. A will lead to B. So then what will happen? Kim U Uktam. U will remain without being replaced by Vakara. It will get Pragriya Sanya and then it will deny Sandhi. So just Varna Melana with Makara will give you Kimu. So Kimu Uktam. You cannot get Savarna Dirgha here. So this is the second form. Kimu Uktam. So either Kim Uktam or Kimu Uktam. इको सवर्णे शाकल्यस्य ह्रस्वश्च पदान्तस्य अचि प्रकृत्या संहितायां संहितायां विषये व्हाट हैपेंस प्रकृत्या प्रकृति भाव व्हेन अचि परे पदान्तस्य शाकल्यस्य मतेन सो इकः इकः इज पंच इज षष्टि इकः असवर्णे असवर्णे अचि सो दीज आर इन सामानादिकरणम असवर्णे अचि परे परसप्तमी इकः स्थाने व्हाट ह्रस्वश्च सो चकार ह्रस्वश्च प्रकृति भाव विल ऑल्सो बी देर प्रकृति भाव एंड ह्रस्व बोथ आर देर मीनिंग वॉट ह्रस्व इज मेड मीनिंग इफ इट इज अ दीर्घ इक इक इज वॉट ई ऊ रील रू सो दैट ई ऊ रील रू विच कैन बी इकार ईकार इत्यादि सो ऑल फ्लेवर्स ऑफ ई ऊ रील रू वेन एट द एंड ऑफ द पदा followed by asavarna ach they can optionally be replaced by hraswa adesha they are not replaced can take hraswa adesha meaning dirgha ityadi can become hraswa dirgha ee oo ril ru can be get hraswa adesha and also prakriti bhava, meaning once rasva is there, there cannot be any further sandhi. See, the reason there cannot be any further sandhi is very logical, because why would Panini Acharya give rasva adesha and then do sandhi? Without the rasva also there will be sandhi. So it would be a wasteful sutra to give it a rasva adesha when you are anyway going to do sandhi. So rasva followed by sandhi makes no sense, because without rasva also same sandhi would have otherwise applied. With an asavarna ach. So ikaha asavarne shakalyasya rasvascha. So cha tells you that padantasya achi prakritya samhitaya prakriti bhava also. Pragriya sanya and then prakriti bhava. So padanta ikaha rasvaha vasyu va. Again vibhasha. So if you take this vibhasha, then rasva will be the adesha. Dirgha will become rasva, and then there won't be any sandhi. If you do not take this vibhasha, then there will be sandhi. So what is the example? Chakri atra. So chakri. Chakri is chakrasya sthiti chakri. Chakrin is the pratipadika. So one who has chakra. So Bhagavan Narayana has chakra. So he will say chakri is Narayana, Krishna va ityadi. So chakri atra. When you have this, then what is the ach is following? Asavarna ach is following. Asavarna, so chakri. If you have chakri here, then chakri ikara is part of ik, which is at the end of the pada chakra. So it's a padanta ikara, which is ik antargata. Then chakri atra. This atra o is asavarna ach, because it is not e savarna, savarna with e. It is asavarna with e. Then this will ikara will take rasva adesha, it will become chakri. So chakri atra. You cannot make sandhi after this. Chakri atra. Now this may appear as what? Chakri makes no sense. As in, it may not make sense, because had it been what? Had it been sambodhana, it should have been he chakrin. It is not sambodhana. So this should tell you that it is not sambodhana. But then what is this chakri? Chakri is ikara, is dirgha, but it has taken rasva adesha and then prakriti bhava by pragriya sanya. It will not have sandhi prakritya because of prakriti bhava. So chakri atra will become chakri. Chakri atra will become chakri atra. No sandhi. So this is one form. If you do not take this vibhasha, as in rasva adesha is not taken and thereby no prakriti bhava, then what will happen? You don't take this vibhasha. This is a va vibhasha. You do not take this, then what will happen? This form. Chakri atra, there will be eko yanachi sandhi and you will get chakri atra. So you'll get the form chakri atra. That is the second form, chakri atra. There will be eko yanachi yana sandhi, you'll get chakri atra. So padanta, I'll not look at the other example unless it is needed. Yeah, it is needed. So the next sutra cannot come unless you use padantaha. Why padantaha? Padantaha iti kim? So this is also the Kashika style. Padantaha iti kim means what? Why would the iko savarne shakalyasya rasvascha sutra have anuvrittya padantasya? Padantaha. Earlier there is some padantaha shabda that has an anuvritti here. Okay, wherever it has come from. So this anuvritti of padantaha, padantasya, padanta iti kim? Why padanta word has been used? So there gauryau is the example, meaning what is a counter example to this sutra. In this it has not taken place. Whatever is the karya of this sutra, it has not taken place. So au. So au, when you say au, e u reel ru. Ik is what? E u reel ru. Now here, when you have Gauri and au, which is what? Let's move ahead and see. So Gauri and au. Gauri is an ikara ending word. Au is following. Now what has happened? This Gauri is a pratipadika. It is not a padanta. It is not a pada. Gauri is a pratipadika. Gauri plus au is pada. Now had padantaha or padantasya not been used in the sutra by anuritti, in the last sutra, then what would happen in this current sutra that we are looking at? So if this padantasya, which has been has undergone case conversion, and we have got padantasya, so padantasya or padanta iti kim means this word. Why is this word needed? Without this word, what would have happened? So if padanta, if you remove, what would happen? That is a question. So if at all you remove padanta, this word is being questioned, padantasya. So had it not been there, then this would apply to non-padanta also, meaning ikkad at the end of the pratipadika also would have taken hraswa. So Gauri, while being derived, Gauri with au. So au is asavarna ach to ikara. This ikara is ik. So ik, ikara, and then au is asavarna ach. Then ikara would have taken hraswa and prakriti bhava, meaning there wouldn't have been any sandhi, which is anishta. You cannot have Gauri and au in a pada. So this Gauri being pratipadika, it is not pada. Thereby this prakriti bhava is denied and you get gaurav. Denied in sense it will not apply. So therefore there will be iko yanchi yana sandhi and you will get gaurav. So that is from gaurav. Now this is called for. Why is this example taken? Although it is padanta iti kim, it may not be needed in the recap, but why it is taken is because in next sutra this achorahabhyam dve cannot be introduced otherwise. So now while you are deriving this Gauri plus au, so what happens is that you get a single yakara, Gauri au, but doubling is possible through what? The next sutra. Thereby the next sutra is introduced by Lagukara saying achorahabhyam dve yaraha va. So again this is va vibhasha. Vibhashaya you will get doubling of yakara, dve. Dve is becoming two. So dve, kasya dve bhavataha. So rahabhyam, achaha rahabhyam, yaraha dve bhavata. Yaraha comes from anuvritti. The sutra is only achaha rahabhyam dve. So achaha parasya yaraha dve va bhavataha. Which ach, which year will take dvitvam as so, this dvitva, yar will take dvitvam, which yat, which yar antargata, yar is a pratyahara, which yar antargata akshara will take dvitva, doubling, that which is preceded by ach, but what, that ach which is rahabhyam, meaning achaha rahabhyam, ach, so there are two panchamis, this is panchami dvivachana rahabhyam, and there is an achaha which is panchami ekvachana. So the yar should be preceded by repha or hakara which is preceded by ach. So it is not directly preceded by ach. It should be preceded by ach, but after ach there should be repha or hakara, meaning ach plus repha or hakara, and then there is a yar letter, then this yar letter will optionally take dvitva. So in the Gauri case, what has happened? You have gaur and yand sandhi is applied, so you have gaur yakara, and then this au pratyaya is ek prathama dvivachana or dvitiya dvivachana pratyaya which is following. Now when you are deriving this, what has happened? You have applied yana sandhi and you have got gaurya au. So what happens? This yakara is what? Yar antargata, it itself is yakara, the first letter itself of yar. Then it is preceded by repha. So repha or hakara, repha is there, so that condition is met. This repha in turn is preceded by aukara, that aukara happens to be ach. Therefore, the condition of achorahabhyam dve yaraha is met, and va vibhasha. If you take vibhasha, then you will get what? Yaraha dve. So yakara will become double and you will get, sorry, then you will get gauryau. So you will get gaurya plus au. This doubling is optional. So either you will get gauryau or gauryau. And in chanting, if you, so this is the same one which is applying to what I think, yeah. So in Gita, when you are chanting Arjuna Uvacha, so this doubling of jakara is also through this Arjuna Uvacha. So it can be Arjuna Uvacha also, but you will see many orthodox chanters. Orthodox means those who have studied in the Vedika chantings. Those who have, there they'll, these optional sandhis are all mandatory. So for example, say कर्ता, सो यू कैन गेट कर्ता. कर्ता इज अ वेरी वेल नोन, सो जनरली यू विल हियर कर्ता, बट देन मोस्ट ऑफ दिस पीपल विल से दिस तकार इज ऑल्सो डबल्ड, कर्ता. सो कर्ता दे विल से कर्ता, कर्तव्य. सो देर इज अ डबलिंग ऑफ तकार ऑल्सो देर, कर्तव्यम, कर्ता, अर्जुन. सो ऑल दैट इज ऑप्शनल संधि, बट ऑप्शनल संधि इन चैंटिंग इज जनरली टेकन एज मैंडेटरी इन चैंटिंग एटलीस्ट, बिकॉज दैट्स ए प्रैक्टिस एनी वे, दैट्स द संप्रदाय, दैट्स एन असाइड. व्याकरण वाइज यू कैन हैव बोथ फॉर्म्स, यू कैन हैव गौर्य और सो वा यरह, दो वा यरह वा वा द्वे, देयर फॉर यू कैन गेट गौर्य और यू कैन गेट गौर्य. सिमिलरली वॉट कीर्ति, कीर्ति इत्यादि, कीर्ति कीर्ति. So this is one form. If you take doubling, if you do not take doubling, then this is second form. It is mentioned elsewhere. Na samasya, I'll skip this unless needed. Rutyakaha, not needed. So we'll go ahead. Rutyakaha. Next sutra is Rutyakaha. Shakalyasya hraswa padantasya prakrutya samhitayam is all from Anuruti. Anuruti. So Rutyakaha is Ruti akaha. So Ruti. Ruti pare, saptami. Ruti pare what? Ruti means Ruti takara taparakarnam has been done, meaning hraswa rukara, rukara, not rukara, rukara. So this rukara should be following. Following what? Ak. Ak is isani, akaha. So ak, which is at the end of the pada, padantasya. Therefore, padanta ak followed by a rukara. Akantargata letter. Ak is a pratyahara. So ak will take. Padanta ak will take hraswa adesha when followed by rukara, and then there will be prakriti bhava, meaning no sandhi. There will be prakriti bhava, no sandhi. So example is what? Brahma rishihi. So Brahma, Brahma cha asau rishischa. Karmadharaya when you make, then in samasa what will happen? Brahma and rishi will have sandhi. In samasa or... it may not be a samasa also, sandhi. So Brahma and Rishi. So when you have Brahma and Rishi, what will happen? Akara will take hraswa. Akara will take hraswa, and then you will get Brahmarshi. This is so Brahma Rishi. This is when pragriya bhava, pragriya sanya, prakriti bhava is taken. Sorry, prakriti bhava is taken. So Brahma Rishi. So hraswa. If it takes hraswa, then there is no sandhi. If it doesn't take hraswa, then Brahmarshihi. Similarly, Mahan Rishihi will become what? Nakara, Nalopa Pratipatikantasya, Padasya, Nakara Lopa takes place there. We'll come across this, but those who have studied, this might trigger the memory. Nakara Lopa, Padanta Nakara, which is the same Nakara which was there at the end of the Pratipadika, will undergo Lopa. Then Mahan Rishi will become Maharishi. Then Maharishi, what are the forms? If you have Sandhi, it will become Maharshi. Similarly, Brahma and Rishi, if you have Sandhi without Prakriti Bhava, you will get Brahmarshi. Now in Brahma and Rishi, what happens? If you do not make a Sandhi, you will take Prakriti Bhava. So if you, when you get this Rutyakaha condition is met, Rukara is following what? Ak. This Akara, which is Akantargata. Pratyahara Akantargata, meaning A. A is A, which is part of Ak. It is followed by, and this is at the end of the pada. Brahma is a declined pada. Suptingantam padam. So Brahma, Prathama Ekvachana, followed by Rukara, Rut. Ruti pare. Will take hraswa adesha. If it takes hraswa adesha, then no sandhi. Brahma rishihi. If you do not take this option, then what will happen? Sandhi. Brahma rishi. There is no hraswa, but akara and rukara, there will be ad guna, guna sandhi, and you will get Brahma rishi. So two forms, Brahma rishi or Brahma rishihi. Do we need this? I'll not take this padanta iti kim. So by this, last sutra we have finished Achandi. So Achandi is over, we'll move on to Hal Sandhi. I'll not go through summary, this is what summary is. So Purvaparihoti summary, Hal Sandhi. So Atha Hal Sandhi. So Hal Sandhi is a consonant Sandhi. Hal also is a, what is this Hal? There are two Hakaras in the Maheshwara Sutras. This is for technical reason. Why? Because otherwise you will not get Hal. Hal is the last Sutra also. This Hal is not the last Sutra, but Hal is a Pratyahara starting with the Hayavarat Sutra, Ha, Hakara. So the entire Hayavarat onwards, Nyamavandana Mityadi, ending with this Hal is the entire Hal. So the first Hakara, this is the first Hakara, not the second Hakara. So Hal is the entire set of consonants, meaning after Ach, Hal. So consonant Sandhi. The first Sandhi is called as Shuttva Shuttva Sandhi. Ramaschete is the example there. So she lists some things like this as to remember what kind of Sandhi is applying. So she will say Ramaschete Sandhi, in the meaning she, in the sense Medha Michikaji, who is the author of these set of books, she will call this as Ramaschete Sandhi, Arjuna Vacha Sandhi Ityadi, so that you have an example and you remember the Sandhi through that. But that has no Vyakrana basis, in the Sutra basis is not there, it's an example. So through the example you remember the Sandhi when you are studying without Sutras, or you do not use Shtutva Shtutva Ityadi words, so then you say Ramaschete Sandhi. So you remember something like that. You don't need to have Parivhashika Shabda such as Shtutva Shtutva, because for that also you need some Vyakrana, whether with or without Sutra, Maheshwara Sutras are needed. Then when you are studying Sutras, you will say this Sutra, Stosh Chunash Chuhu. This is the first Sutra in Laghu, in Hal Sandhi. So it's a Vidhi Sutra. What does it say? Stosh Chunash Chu. And earlier I had mentioned that whenever you have third case, this is third case singular, and Chu is the first case singular, Sto is sixth case singular. So whenever you have third case in the Sutra, that third case, I mean, of course, unless the other Karaka Ityadi Arthas apply, that's a different story. But Paribhashika meaning of the third case in the Sutra is what? It's a bidirectional Sandhi. Meaning what? This Stoho, Sakara or Takara, Sakara or Takara, this is Sakara is one, Takara, what is Takara? Two has become, so not Takara, Tavarga. So Tavarga, Sakara or Tavarga is this Thani. So that will take what Adesha? Shankar Shakara, first Adesha, or Tavarga will become Chavarga, meaning Tav will become Chakara respectively. Takara will become Chakara, then or rather let's say Tata Dhadana will respectively become what? Chacha Jhajanya. That is the two becoming Chu. So Sa will become Shankar Shakara, Sakara will become Shankar Shakara, and Ta Varga will become Cha Varga letter respectively, whichever is the Sthana in that Varga. Varga Tritya will become Varga Tritya Ityadi. So this not Varga Tritya, Varna. So the is when you say two, Ta Varga. So yeah, Ta Varga, and so Varga Tritya of Ta Varga will become Varga Tritya of Cha Varga. Varga Prathama of Ta Varga will become Varga Prathama of the Cha Varga. So on is the replacement. But when there is a Sandhi with Shankar Shakara or Cha Varga letter, so the same is the Adesha. Whatever is the Chuna, that is this Chu also. Chu is declared in third case as Chuna. So whatever is Sandhi, whatever is the Adesha that I have explained, that Adesha is for whatever precedes or follows, that is the third case. So Shankar Shakara precedes Shakara or Tavarga, then what will happen? The actually I should not say or, because Sakara or Tavarga is there. So Sakara will become Shankar Shakara when followed by Shankar Shakara or Chavarga. And Tavarga letter will become what? Will become Shankar Shakara, Chavarga letter when followed by Shankar Shakara or Chavarga. So this is the general case when you have this, either you say following or preceding. But third case shows bidirectional Sandhi, meaning this Shchu. Now I'll say Shchu. When Shchu is preceding or following Stu, then Stu will respectively become Shchu. It is not on what precedes or what follows which takes the Adesha, but Adesha will always be to Stu whether Shchu is preceding or following. Adesha will always be for Stu. So it's a bidirectional Sandhi that is shown here as सकारा और त वर्गा लेटर विल टेक शंकर शकारा और च वर्गा आदेशा व्हेन प्रीसीडेड बाय शंकर शकारा और च वर्गा लेटर और फॉलोड बाय शंकर शकारा और च वर्गा लेटर. सो देयर आर टू डायग्राम्स टू शो दैट प्रीसीडिंग और फॉलोइंग. व्हाट टेक्स आदेशा दिस सकारा और त वर्गा टेक्स आदेश ऑफ शंकर शकारा और च वर्गा. सविता विषय. सो व्हाट आर द एग्जांपल्स. रामशेते एज वी सॉ रामस दिस राम प्लस सू विल बिकम रामस. सो राम इफ यू डिक्लाइन इट जनरली विल से राम शेते बिकॉज इन द वाक्य दे विल बी रिटन विद द पदा सेपरेटेड. सो पदा विल बी डिराइव्ड फर्स्ट एंड देन यू विल अप्लाई बट जनरली संधि डज नॉट टेक प्लेस दैट वे. संधि टेक्स प्लेस इन डेरिवेशन इटसेल्फ एज टू राम स सू सू स दैट सकार रामस शेते will become what the sakara by saso jusho ruhu. We'll see this sutra more. Saso jusho ruhu applies and ruhu is a technical. Ukara is added to repha and something called as ruhu is created by Panini Maharshi to separate this from repha. Repha which is known generally and ruhu is also repha but it is with an ith letter of ukara. So it is ruhu, nasalized ukara ruhu. Anunasika ukara is there. So this ru is the adesha for sakara saso jusho ru. So sakara or sajush will take ru adesha and then ramas will become ramaru. This ramaru is what ukara will go away. It will become ramar really. And then kharavas anayor visarjaniyaha. So ramashete is the adesha but this will not remain visarga. सो खर अवसानयोर विसर्जनीय दिस रू विल वी टेक विसर्जनीय आदेश. दिस विसर्जनीय इज विसर्ग. दिस विसर्ग इज नॉट द फॉर्म. वाई इट कैन बी बट देन वाशरी विसर्जनीय से सह. सो राम विसर्ग शेते दिस इज वन पॉसिबल फॉर्म. इफ यू टेक वाशरी वेन शर फॉलोज दिस शकार इज शर अंतर्गत. सो दिस विसर्ग नॉट दिस नॉट हियर. So there is a difference in how it is noted. I prefer that wherever the sutra is applied, there you know the sutra is to be I write sutras. Meaning, if you have followed my earlier classes, then I write sutras at the step that it is applying. So here in this book, there is a difference as to this kharavasana or visarjaniya sutra applies, and then you get this form Ramashete. I prefer to apply this write the sutra at this level. So Ramashete here I would have written kharavasana. खरवसानयोर विसर्जनीय. सो हियर रामरू. सो रामरू हियर सी फॉर एग्जांपल हियर रामरू शेते ससोजुशरू इज हैव बीन अप्लाइड हियर बट देन खरवसानयोर इट हैज बीन अप्लाइड हियर. ओके सो नो इट इज राइट द वे आई हैव यूज्ड टू यूज द मेथडोलॉजी इन माय क्लासेस द सेम थिंग हैज बीन अप्लाइड हियर. So what has happened here is that vashari, if you do not take this option, then you will have what? Visarga. So this visarga would have remained. This visarga is what? Visarjaniya, which is an adesha for ru khara vasane, when khara or avasana follows. This shete shakara is khara antargata, khara pratyahara antargata shakara. So khapa chatata chatata o kapai shashasar. So therefore shakara is part of that. So khar, when khar or avasana, meaning a pause follows, then you will have visarga. This ru will become visarga. So this is one possible form. Why one possible form? Because vashari is there. If you take an option of when shar follows, then this visarjani is sa optionally. So then it will become visarga will become sakara. Again, this where you started off, it will come back to that sakara. So you have to go from sakara to ru to visarga to sakara. So having gone to this sakara, taking that option, that sakara, then there will be a stoshchunashchu. You cannot apply stoshchunashchu directly because it has to go through all the steps in tripadi. So having reached this sakara, this is the first time A. So A sakara is different from this B sakara. You have to go through ru and visarga to get to the B sakara. So this sakara when it is there, then this is a padanta sakara because ramas you have derived. Now there is nothing more to do. Either you have this ramah shete or you have ramas shete. Now the sandhi, padanta sandhi will apply as to stosh chunaschu because samhitayam only is there, but it can be at the end of the pada, but you have to go through the sits in the fourth pada of the eighth chapter. You have to go through the second pada, third pada, two sutras, then only you land on the fourth pada of the eighth chapter in the Tripadi sequence, and thereby you will get this sandhi as to stosh chunash chuhu. Therefore this sakara, which is followed by what? This sakara, which is either preceded or followed by shankar shakara, will take shankar shakara adesha. So therefore this sakara will become shankar shakara, you will get ramashyete. Similarly, what ramas chinoti, here what has happened, this sakara has become room, then it has become visarga, then it has come back to visarga, then it is no coming back, meaning there is no coming back, but it is followed by char. So then it progresses. No, I should not say coming back, it progresses to another different sakara. Why? Because chakara is following. What is this chakara? This chakara is part of khar. So kharavasana, so you have this kharavasana or visarjaniya, and then visarjaniya se saha. Sa is vashari. Shasasar. No, it is not shasasar. But here itself, kharavasana or visarjaniya, it will not take visarjaniya adesha at all. So it will just be sasojusho ru, and then stosh chunash chu. Then when it lands to, she has not derived this. This is, she has not derived, it doesn't look like she has given the details of how it has been derived. But what happens is that you can start with Ramas Chinoti. So we'll also stick to that, not go through all the steps. But then this Sakara followed by Chakara, that's the scenario. Chakara preceding or following is what? Chavarga. So Chavarga will also push this Sakara to Shankar Shakara, and therefore it will become what? Ramas Chinoti. Satchit. So takara is tavarga. Takara will also become what? Chavarga. First letter, because takara is first letter, you will get satchit. Satchit will become satchit. And so on. So there is negation which are following. So next sutra is a Nisheda Sutra. What is it? It is also Nisheda is also Vidhi, really. Vidhi Sutra only, but it is Nishedatmaka. It is not going to give you some end result. It is going to deny a result which has already been ordained by a Vidhi Sutra. Therefore, it is a Vidhi Sutra which is Nishedatmaka, Nisheda Sutra. Shat. So, Shat Toho Na Chuhu Samhitayam. So, this Toho Chunas Chuhu had ordained this Chutvam to Tavarga letters. So Tavarga letter taking Chutvam will not take place when Samhitayam Vishaye, when Shat. Shat means when Tavarga is preceded by Shakara. Shat is Panchami Ekvachana of Sha. This Akara is for pronunciation. So of Shakara really. So Akara in the Shat is for pronunciation, and therefore it is declined as Akaranta. But that akara basically it means only shakara there. So shakara is preceding the tavarga. This tosh chunash chu should have applied, and shakara should have taken tavarga should have taken chavarga adesha. So chu, this is denied. Why? This shakara preceding shat, only when the shakara is preceding, then this chutvam is denied. So example is what? So here it is mentioned, akara after this shakara is for pronunciation. Example, vishna. So vishna. So what happens here? The example is as to why, when it is not to be applied, that is mentioned here. So stosh chunash chu. This where is this shat? Shat is 8444, and stosh chunash chu is 8440. So now if you apply stosh chunash chu, then you, this 44 shat will have no place to apply, because if it has already taken the sandhi, then this nisheda cannot apply. So that is what is mentioned here. Therefore what happens here is that example is this. So let's take this example of what? To illustrate, vish and na. What is the laghu example there? So I would have liked to go through directly to Laghu example. This book is a little tricky, as in there are a lot of discussion. That discussion is useful when you are studying for the first time, but for recap, it is not useful. It is misguiding. So that's why let me see if I can directly go to the Laghu example. Ajanta Pullinga. Ajanta Pullinga is later. Just I'm looking through the book. It is easier to step through. Palsandhi. Gyashat. So yeah, Vishna. So daily state mention. This is also a Laghu example. So Vish plus Na. So what happens here? So if you get this Vishna, this is. Let me mark this as wrong. So had this been applied, so that is what he said. Vish plus Na. So this Na is what? Ta antargata. Ta varga. So ta varga letter. Ta Na. Ta varga. Panchama. So if you apply stushtu nashtu, you will get this, but this is not to be applied. That is what is being said, and you will get the form Vishnaha. And similarly, what Vishnaha, then Prash plus Na, also they will get Prashnaha, not Nyakara. You will got Nakara will not be replaced by Nyakara, it will remain Prashna. Okay. Then the next sutra is Tunashtuhu. So Shtutva Sandhi Stoho Samhitayam. So this Tunashtu Kasya. कस्य भवति स्तोहो सो स्तोहो इज षष्ठी एकवचन स्तोहो व्हाट हैपेंस जस्ट दैट स्तो मीनिंग सकार और त वर्ग लेटर व्हिच वाज प्रीसीडेड और फॉलोड बाय श्चु वाज टेकिंग श्चु आदेश सिमिलरली प्रीसीडेड बाय श्चु विल टेक और फॉलोड बाय प्रीसीडेड और फॉलोड बाय श्चु विल टेक श्चु आदेश दैट्स ऑल द डिफरेंसेस सो इंस्टेड ऑफ द सेम स्थानी इंस्टेड ऑफ प्रीसीडेड और फॉलोड बाय श्चु यू हैव श्चु That's the difference between the sandhi, that's all. So Rama Shashtaha, you will become Rama Shashtaha. You will get Shadmukh Shakara Adesha. The next is Rama Shtikate. Rama Shtikate, you will become Rama Shtikate. And so on. So I think this is easy. Not much to do there. Na Padanta Toranam Stoha Samhitayam. So another denial. So this Shtutva will not take place for Sakara or Tavarga letter when Naam. So Padanta Tavarga is preceding, but not of Naam. So what is being said is that, so Anam, the Anam in the case of, so Anam, Anam iti kim should be there. So this Anamaha stohoshtuhu nasyat. What is that? Padanta Tavarga parasya, Padanta Tavarga letter. Which is what? Padanta Tavarga letter. That is the Nimitta. For what? Parasya Anamaha Stoho. So this Stu, which is following this Padanta Tavarga letter, that Stu will not take Stu. Anamaha Stu will, meaning if it is Naam, then it will take. But it is Anam, so Anamaha. So this Anama is also Shashti. It is qualifying Stu. And then Na. So what is it? The negation of Tutva, that is indicated by Na. Padantat. Padantat is Tu which is preceding. And the Anam, Na Naam iti Anam. So Naam indicates Aam. What is this Aam? Shashti Bahuvachana. So in Shashti Bahuvachana Pratyaya you have Aam. That Aam which has taken the Agama that will become Naam, and then Nattvam is there, you get what? Ramana Mityadi. So that Naam is Aam, Aam Pratyaya, and Anam is mentioned, meaning it should not be this Shashti Bahuvachana. So Padanta Tavargat Parasya Anamaha Stoho Shtu Nasyat. Shtuhu Nasyat, Shtutvam is not going to take place. So Shat Santaha, example is Shat Santaha. So Shat Santaha, what has happened? This Takara, Shat Takara is the Tavarga letter, which is otherwise a Nimitta for Sakara. This Sakara Stoho Santaha is Stoho Antar, this Stu Antargata Sakara. That Sakara would have taken what? Should have taken Shtutvam as per the earlier Sutra. Now it is denied. And this takara, this is what it is. Shat is what? Prathama bahuvachana. It has nothing to do with the shashti bahuvachana. So there, it is not shashti bahuvachana. Therefore, this takara will not become nimitta for santa sakara to become shadmukh sakara. So you will not say shat and then shanta, but you will have santaha. There is no stutva. Shatte, again this takara is not become. Will not become takara by stutva sandhi. Why? Because this takara of shat is at the end of the pada and it is not the shashti bahuvachana. So id stutav. So here also padantad iti kim. So here where it padantad is added, otherwise there would be denial in itte also. That should not take place. Therefore, counter example is given and so on. Vartika, I'll skip. Shannam. So the example is shannam. So what I said is that Vartika, since Shannam is quite common, so anam navati nagari nam iti vachyam na padanta toho stoho shtu. So what I said is that this when you said anam, meaning not shashti bahuvachana, there this nam navati nagari, that also should have been mentioned. Why? Because you've seen example shat plus naam. When you have shat plus naam, then you get this shad plus naam. So this anam you say, but then this shat plus aam has become shat plus naam by nudagama. So nudagama is there, shat charubhyascha nut. So you'll get nudagama, you'll get shash and naam. Shash and naam will become jalam jashwante, will give you shad plus naam. So shad plus naam, what happens? It becomes shannam finally. So this also should be mentioned as to Vartika. Then Navati also, Shan Navati. So Navati Nagari. So Nagari is also Shan Nagareha, Shan Nagareha. So there the denial does not apply, Shtutvam does take place. So it should have been mentioned as an exception to the exception sutra through Vartika. Toshi is a sutra. Na Shtuhu Samhitayam is the Anuvritti. So in this case also, Toho Shi Pare. So she is Saptami. So when Shakara, Shanmukh Shakara follows what? Tu, Ta Varga, then also Shtutvam is denied. Just like we saw Shat. In the Shat Sutra, we saw the denial. Similarly here, in the Shtutva Sandhi is denied. There the Shat, the Shtutvam was denied. Cha Varga Adesha for Ta Varga was denied. Now here, Shtutva Sandhi is denied for Ta Varga to become take the Shtutva Adesha, become Tavarga when followed by Shakara. So Shanmukh Shakara precedes the Shtutvam. Shtutvam was denied. Now Shankar Shakara, you just go back and show this Shat. See, Shat had denied. So Shat had denied when Shankar Shakara precedes Tavarga, Shtutvam was denied. Now what is being done? When Shanmukh Shakara follows, then Shtutvam is denied. Shtutvam is denied for Ta Varga letter. So here, when Ta Varga letter is followed by Shanmukh Shakara, earlier what? Preceded by Shankar Shakara, then this Shtutvam was denied. Now this same Tu followed by Shanmukh Shakara, Shtutvam is denied. So example, what is the example? So here you have example, San Shashtaha. So San Shashtaha, San is Shatrantha Pada, San. San Ghataha, San Pata iti vat, San Shashtaha. So Shashtaha, sixth. So the being the sixth. So the meaning can be being the sixth. Being the sixth, sixth whatever. So Shashtaha, Shashtaha means sixth. So San, being sixth. So in that case, what San is, Nakara is, Tavargantara, so Nakara is Tu. This is Shanmukh Shakara, which is Shtu Antargata. So this is Shtu. So here this Shtutvam should have taken place. Nakara should have taken Natvam. That's the idea. Shtutvam will have given it Nakara. Not Natvam, but Shtutvam. So it would have become Nakara. Should have. So, but here the denial is there. So San Shashtaha. It is not San Shashtaha. In fact, it is difficult to pronounce also. So San Shashtaha. The next sutra, which is the most common Padanta Sandhi, which will apply in many or most cases, that is a Vidhi Sutra, Jhalan Jashwante. So Jhalan Jashwante. पदस्य पदस्य इज अनुवृत्ति सो इट्स अ पदांत संधि यू हैव अनदर जस्टम विच इज नॉट अ पदांत संधि बाय झलाम जस्ट झशी विच विल फॉलो देर इज अनदर सूत्र दैट विल कम अप सो दिस जस्टम इज डिजायरेबल इफ इट इज नॉट टेकिंग प्लेस ड्यू टू सम अदर चेंज इन बिटवीन मीनिंग दिस जस्टम हैज टेकन प्लेस एंड समथिंग एल्स हैज कॉज इट टू चेंज टू बिकम वॉट क वर्गा इत्यादि समथिंग एल्स हैज हैपन्ड or it has been protected and jashtum has not taken place properly. I'm just mentioning, explaining as to why jhalam jash jashi also comes up. So this jhalam jash, adesha, jash adesha, jash is what? Varga tritiya. Jash is varga tritiya, jabagada dash. So this varga tritiya adesha for jhal is desirable. And if it has not taken place or has changed its forms in between, then jhalam jash, same jhalam jash, but not ante, jashi. So jashi will come up as to when jash follows. Jhakara and shanmukh shakara, jash, that will follow. So jashtum is needed, it is desirable for the, in the tripadi, so it will, there is another jashtum that comes up later. So what is the sutra saying? There is nothing to follow or all that. Padanta, the jhal at the end of the pada will take jash varga tritiya adesha. What is jhal? Jhal itself will be jhavai. Starting with jhavai means fifth of the class, fourth of the class, third of the class, second of the class, sorry, not fifth, fourth of the class. Yamagananam is removed. So fourth of the class, third of the class, second of the class, and varga prathama. Then kapai shasha sar. Shasa sar. Sar, then hal hakara. So this is jhal. So varga chaturtha onwards, downwards, sha sha sa and ha. And ha, these are part of jhal. They will take jashtvam, meaning the jashtvam is varga tritiya. So varga tritiya will be the adesha for all of these. What all takes is restricted, but then jhal is a common word pratyahara which is used here. It is a common sandhi, there is no other condition. So jhal is quite vast, unless it is the vowel or the varga panchama letter, all the letters will take jashtvam. Basically all consonants except for the five and the semi vowels, they will all take jashtvam. That is the idea. So what was the example here? पदान्ते झलाम जश्यु वाचा ईशः वागीशः सो दैट्स अ षष्ठी तत्पुरुष समास इन समास व्हाट हैज हैपेंड वाच इज अ स्त्रीलिंग पद वाच प्लस न्यस इन षष्ठी वाचः ईशः दि लॉर्ड ऑफ स्पीच लॉर्ड ऑफ वाक सो ईश ईश्वर ईश्वर ईश प्लस सु प्रथम एक वचन सो न्यस एंड सु विल गो अवे बाय सुपो धातु प्रातिपदिकयो एंड प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा फॉर समास इज बाय कृत तद्धित समासाश्च सो कृत 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 अंत कृदंत तद्धितांत एंड समास ऑल ऑफ दीज विल गेट प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा दिस अ सेकंड सूत्र प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा इज बाय टू सूत्र आई थिंक अर्लियर इज वॉट अर्थवत् अधातु अप्रत्यय प्रातिपदिकम सो दैट विच इज अर्थवत् अधातु दैट शुड नॉट बी अ धातु एंड विच शुड नॉट बी अ प्रत्यय दैट विल गेट प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा वॉट एल्स विल गेट प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा कृत कृत प्रत्यय अंत देन तद्धित प्रत्यय अंत एंड समास प्रत्यय अंत विच हैज स्टिल नॉट टेकन सुप्रत्यय इट विल टेक सुप्रत्यय बिकॉज इट इज अ प्रातिपदिक बाय दिस सूत्र कृत समासाश्च सो इट गेट्स प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा वॉट गेट्स दिस एंटायर थिंग वाच plus nyas plus isha plus su then these are supratyas within a pratipadika so within a pratipadika itself you cannot have supratyas should be added later so which are already added because these two were individually padas this was a pada and this was a second pada so there was a pada 1 so pada 1 and pada 2 were already there they are in samasa therefore you got a pratipadika vach plus nyas plus isha plus su This nyas and su should be dropped by what? Supodhatu pratipadikayoho luk. So this sup will take luk. Which sup will take luk? Meaning elided. विधिन धातु और प्रातिपदिका. सो दिस इज अ प्रातिपदिका. विधिन धातु एग्जाम्पल इज अ डिराइव्ड धातु. व्हेन यू आर डिराइविंग अ धातु नाम धातु फ्रॉम अ नाउन, इफ यू आर डिराइविंग अ धातु देन द नाउन विल हैव इट्स अ पदा फ्रॉम अ पदा यू आर डिराइविंग. सो वॉट विल हैपन इज दैट इट विल हैव अंतर्गत देयर विल बी अ सुप. दैट सुप प्रत्यय शुड बी ड्रॉप्ड इन अ धातु. सो इन अ धातु दिस एग्जाम्पल इज अ प्रातिपदिका. सो दैट विच हैज गॉट अ प्रातिपदिका संज्ञा बाय कृत्तद्वित समासाश्च दैट will lose the nyas and su sup pratyas and you will get watch plus isha. Now watch plus isha, what has happened? This watch plus nyas has lost nyas, but watch plus nyas was already a prati, already a pada. So this p is pada. So I'll write pada. Pratipadika is also p. So pada. So this first pada in samasa with second pada, first pada is in shashti vachaha. That shashtiyanta pada which has lost its nyas pratyaya will still retain its pada sanya. Pada sanya will not go away by dropping the pratyaya. Pratyaya has gone away, does not reverse it back to pratipadika, it will remain a pada. So thereby vach is a pada, and then this vach chakara is what? It is a jhal. So this vach chakara is a jhal which is also what? Padanta. Padanta jhal. This padanta jhal without any condition as to what follows. It is not a sandhi between a hull and a vowel. Hull and ach can never have sandhi. There is an ach sandhi which is between two ach. Hull sandhi is between two hull. So this is not a sandhi between ach and hull. There is never a sandhi between ach and hull. There is only varna melana. So here what is happening? This chakara, independently, this is a padanta, and padanta sandhi is at the end of the pada, there is a sandhi. So what is a sandhi? Padanta means there is an avasana there. There is something, meaning it's a pada, it is an uttered pada, vachaha. So when you say vachaha, then you say what? Vachaha ishaha. As soon as you uttered vachaha, which is a pada, then to make a samasa, this will lose its nyas. When it loses its nyas, then still vach will be a pada, and that chakara at the end of the pada, which is jhal, padanta jhal, will take jashtvam by jhalam jash ante, jhalam jasho ante. Jhalam jasho ante will make this chakara the third of the class. So the third of the class for this cha is what? It should be, but then before that there is another sutra which has not been covered here. Choku will apply, and then it will become vak. Vach will become vak. Cha varga by choku. Cha varga will become ka varga. This is the sutra which precedes. So when you are applying the sandhi, jhalam jashvante applies. But jhalam, before jhalam jashvante, kuttom has taken place. Cha varga letter has become ka varga respectively. So cha happens to be first of the class, cha varga. Ka happens to be the first of the class or ku. Therefore, cha is replaced by ka. So you will get vach will become vak. And then jhalam jashvante will give you vag. Kakara will become third of the class, not chakara third of the class, but chakara is converted, there is a class conversion to kavarga. Then there is a third of the class adesha, ka, ka, ga. So the kakara is the adesha, you get vag, vagishaha. Then there is varna milanam, there is only vagisha is varna milanam. Okay, we'll do this in the next part, next sutra. तावसाने नटराजराजो ननादटक्कान्नवपञ्चवारम् उद्धर्तु कामः सनकादिसिद्धानि तद्विमर्शे शिवसूत्रजालम्. नमस्ते, धन्यवादः. I'll see you in the next part.
धन्यवादः.
धन्यवादः.